of discussion is on the sermon at Banaras. About the author, this story is written by Betty Renshaw Barber Clinton. Ms. Betty Lewis Renshaw Barber was born in Shannon, Mississippi on September 3, 1927 to PC and Lillian Renshaw. After graduating valedictorian from Shannon High School, she went on to obtain her Bachelor of Arts degree from Mississippi College and later a Master of Arts from Mississippi University for Women. She taught at the preschool level for several years, and eventually she was able to pass her experiences on to others by teaching preschool teachers. Betty married Joseph Henry Barber Jr. on December 23, 1950. They were married for 61 years. Introduction. The sermon at Banaras throws light upon the early life of Lord Buddha, who was originally born as a prince in the royal family. On being exposed to the suffering of the world, which he was earlier shielded from, he left his princehood and went in search of salvation, thus leaving all the worldly pleasures behind. Upon attaining spiritual awakening, he gave his first sermon in the city of Banaras, hereby making a lady named Kisha Gautami realize that men are mortal and a wise person should not grieve at what is bound to happen, for it only enhances pain and suffering. Summary. Gautam Buddha was born to a North Indian royal family as a prince and was named Siddhartha Gautama. When he was 12 years old, he was sent to a faraway place to study Hindu sacred scriptures, and upon returning 4 years later, he got married to a princess. Soon they both had a son, and they continued to live their royal life for about 10 years. The royals were shielded from all the unpleasant experiences of the world until one day, on his way to hunt, the prince met a sick man, an aged man, a funeral procession, and a monk begging for alms. These experiences acted as an eye-opener for him, and thus he left all the royalty behind to seek a higher sense of spiritual knowledge. Upon attaining salvation, he began preaching. He gave his first sermon in the city of Banaras. There was a lady named Kisha Gautami whose son had died. Suffering with unending pain, she went from house to house looking for a medicine to bring her son back to life. People started thinking that the lady had lost her senses. One day, she met a man who directed her towards Lord Buddha, who could possibly have a solution for her problem. Buddha asked her to look for mustard seeds, and the seeds must be procured from a house that had seen no death. Restated with hope, Kisha Gautami once again went on in search from house to house, but to her dismay, she could not find mustard seeds from a house that could fulfill Buddha's condition. Disheartened, she sat at the edge of the road, thus realizing how selfish she had been. She became conscious to the fact that men were mortal and no one could escape the cycle of life. This was exactly what Buddha wanted her to understand. According to Lord Buddha, feeling of grief and sorrow only increases man's pain and suffering, thus deteriorating his health. Therefore, a wise person fully aware about nature's functioning must not grieve at something bound to happen, and only then he can be happy and blessed. Important questions. Then her son dies. Kisha Gautami goes from house to house. Why does she ask for? Does she get it? Why not? When her son dies, Kisha Gautami goes from house to house requesting for a wonder drug that could bring her son back to life. No, she couldn't get it because there is no drug that can bring a dead man back to life. Question 2. Kisha Gautami again goes from house to house after she speaks with the Buddha. What does she ask for the second time around? Does she get it? Why not? Upon seeing the Buddha, Kisha Gautami is refilled with hope, and thus she goes again from house to house looking for mustard seeds, just as Lord Buddha asked her for many mustard seeds offered, but none of them could fulfill Lord Buddha's condition of having seen no death in the family. Therefore, she couldn't find mustard seeds for her son. Question 3. What does Kisha Gautami understand the second time that she failed to understand the first time? Was this what Buddha wanted her to understand? When Kisha Gautami failed to understand and find mustard seeds that could fulfill Lord Buddha's condition of having seen no death in the family, she became disheartened. After deep reflection, she realized that man's fate was just like the city lights that flickered and extinguished repeatedly. The cycle of death and birth was nature's way of working. Suddenly, she became conscious as to how selfish she had been in her sorrow and that one who was born must rest eternally. Men are mortal, yes. This is exactly what Lord Buddha wanted her to understand. Question 4. Why do you think Kisha Gautami understood this only the second time? In what way did the Buddha change her understanding? Kisha Gautami was too overwhelmed with sorrow and pain that her ability to think clearly got clouded. She couldn't realize that no one can escape the cycle of death. When Kisha Gautami failed to find mustard seeds that could fulfill Lord Buddha's condition of having seen no death in the family, she became disheartened. After deep reflection, she made peace with the terms of the world. Lord Buddha played a major role in facilitating the shift in her understanding by teaching her a lesson that one must not grieve for what is bound to happen, for it only deepens the pain and suffering. Thank you.